Hello everybody, my name is Zohir Chaudhry and today we'll talk about water quality regulations. So what is source water? Source water is untreated water from streams, rivers, lakes, or underground aquifers, which is used to supply private wells and public drinking water. Preventing drinking water contamination at the source makes good public health, economic, and environmental sense. As seen in this diagram, source water can be divided into surface water and groundwater. Surface water is waters located in lakes, ponds, streams, rivers, storage reservoir, and ocean. Groundwater, on the other hand, is water from open wells, tube wells, artesian wells, springs, and water from infiltration. In here, we can see a healthy watershed in different places of the U.S. We can see one in Minnesota and the other one in Oregon. Both are clean water with low agricultural runoff. Ensuring the proper health of a watershed means that all the surface water and groundwater sources will be healthy, which in turn will ensure sources of safe and clean drinking water. EPA enforces federal clean water and safe drinking water laws, provides support for municipal wastewater treatment plants, and takes part in pollution prevention efforts aimed at protecting watersheds and sources of drinking water. The United States has two major water quality laws, one, the Clean Water Act, or CWA, and two, Safe Drinking Water Act, or SDWA. You should know these terms by the full name as well as by the contraction. In addition to these two, there are additional laws and regulations that play a very important role in protecting the water in the United States. They are the National Environmental Policy Act, or NEPA, and the Endangered Species Act, or ESA. The Clean Water Act, or CWA, establishes the basic structure for regulating discharges of pollutants into the waters of the United States and regulating quality standards for surface waters. CWA applies only to surface waters, such as rivers, lakes, estuaries, coastal waters, and wetlands. This is extremely important to know where the CWA applies. Essentially, CWA does not apply for the groundwater. On the other hand, the Safe Drinking Water Act is another act that applies to the drinking water that we use. In the U.S., the average person uses 100 gallons of drinking water per day. Of the drinking water supplied by public water systems, only a small portion is actually used for drinking. We use most water for other purposes, such as flushing toilets, bathing, cooking, cleaning, and watering lawns. However, this water must meet strict drinking water quality standards as set by the Safe Drinking Water Act, or SDWA. The Safe Drinking Water Act protects the quality of drinking water in the U.S., focuses on all waters actually or potentially designed for drinking use, whether from above ground or underground sources. Under this act, the US EPA is authorized to establish national enforceable health standards for contaminants in drinking water. SDWA originally passed in 1974 and focused on treatment as the means of providing safe drinking water. In 1996, it was further amended to important components by recognizing source water protection, operator training, funding for water systems, system improvement, and public information. In this slide, we can see the difference between CWA and SDWA. In general term, the SDWA addresses drinking water discharges to groundwater and water systems that deliver drinking water to the public. On the other hand, CWA is the counterpart of the SDWA. It regulates wastewater discharges to surface water, supports the creation and rehabilitation of wastewater treatment plants, and protects surface water. Some overlap obviously exists between these two statutes. However, as a basic rule, the SDWA is concerned with public health associated with safe drinking water, while the CWA has a broader goal of clean, fishable, and swimmable waters, and mostly and predominantly applies to surface water. And in here, you can see roles and responsibility under the Safe Drinking Water Act, and you can see that the various costs associated with ensuring the highest quality of water is eventually passed on to the consumers, who are the ultimate users. In here, we can see EPA personnel testing for water and sampling water to ensure that the water quality meets the guidelines needed. So quick concept checks. Which of the following is not controlled under the CWA? E, groundwater. Another concept check. Under the Clean Water Act, the US EPA has the authority to protect the surface water of the United States. True or false? True. Mm-hmm. All right, that's all.